I don't do shy really well. So anyway, here's a rant. We all pretty much know each other in this room. Because I'm cute. Okay. We know each other in here. We're all over the United States, and other organizations like Partners in Torah, Ace Discovery Partners, if I'm not mistaken, Lubavitch has some sort of partner program. We need to get together via the phone or via Skype, whatever it is, and we need to study together. We need to come up with a program within this group, within the Oklahoma B'nai Noach Society. What we need to do is we need to get ourselves some study partners. Now, does the partner need to be some sort of Torah scholar? Uh-uh. The two of you need to sit down with a divine code and go over a paragraph, go over a page, go over a section. Discuss it between the two of you. If you have questions, email me or bring it up in class. It is not possible for you to pick up the divine code or pick up Torah by yourself and go through it and understand what it's all about. You need somebody who has a little different point of view, has a little different slant, and you may look at it through different eyes. I would strongly suggest 2 hours a week. If you can't do two, do one, but at least one, hopefully two. And here's what you're going to do. You're going to call somebody, and you're going to talk to each other via the private line, PMing. Gentlemen, study with gentlemen. Ladies, study with ladies, please. Okay? That just seems to be the safest and the best way to do it. The last thing you need is to have a gentleman calling a lady on the phone to study. That does not work out well. Okay? So here's what you're going to do. You're going to find somebody, and if you would like, you can submit your name to Oki, and Oki will be more than happy to gather a group of names and put you two together. Now, not all, because girls have cooties. Akiba, he's 14. Akiba, Akiba. Yes, girls have cooties, okay? So for right now, Akiba, girls have cooties. You stay on your side of the machitza, and you'll be good to go. All right? Now, what I would do is I would send your email address to Oki. And what they can do is they can make suggestions. Now, understand, let's suppose that Bonnie calls Devorah. I'm going to pick on you two because you just happen to be there on the screen. And Devorah and Bonnie talk on the phone for about an hour just to get to know each other. And there is zero chemistry. Nothing clicks. Bonnie's a nice lady. Devorah's a nice lady. But you get into a conversation with somebody and the conversation just dies. There are some people that you talk to that when you talk with them, it is an exchange, and after an hour of talking to them, it has just been an absolute pleasure either talking or listening to you. Okay? There are people like that. So, if you end up with a study buddy who you don't click with, no chemistry, that's not the end of the world. Don't take it personally, because guess what? There are some people that I have met that I sit with that in 2 minutes, I have nothing to say to this person. Not at all. I just sit there and listen here. And they talk and they talk and they talk. I go, yeah, yeah. And nothing's been exchanged. Nothing's happened. But you need to find a person you have chemistry with, that would be a good study buddy. And the two of you find something, whether it's a chunk out of the seven laws, whether it's a chunk out of the divine code, whether it's Torah, whatever it is. You might want to sit down and go over the parsha of Noah in detail with a whole lot of commentaries. You know, and maybe Bonnie has commentaries of Rashi, and maybe Dvorla has commentaries from the Rambam, and someone else has commentaries in the Ramban, and you get together and you have a wonderful, wonderful hour study. I have, over the years, had some study buddies. It just has not worked out. You know, it's just, there's no chemistry. I talk to the guy and there's nothing. And that's okay. I just call, hey, it's not going to work, man. So what I would strongly suggest is each one of you take a real good look at yourself, figure out what you think you would like to study, send either a text message or an email to Oki and say, hey, I am a male, this is my age, I'm looking to study the Divine Code. Can you find me a study buddy? Now, those of you out there that are watching this video, again, you might want to take the Oklahoma B'nai Noach Society, send them an email and say, hey, I want a study buddy, because, you know, there are hits. We got over 100 countries coming in and downloading this stuff. Over 100 countries. There's hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of people watching this video each month. Maybe not this one, maybe ones where I have the little thing with a repeller on my head, but they listen. And those people who see that, you need... Francis, you can always do Skype. If you have a camera on your computer, download Skype, put it in, and you can have it in a telephone exchange with somebody. It works really well. Skype works really well. For those of you who don't know, this is Mystery Juice. This Mystery Juice consists of lemonade and iced tea. It is killer. Yeah, and Skype is free, computer to computer. So if Francis wanted to call my wife and talk to her, you can do Skype. Okay? But the idea is 1 hour, at least 1 hour a week. I've had one study buddy now for over 12 years. Over 12 years, the same study buddy. And it's remarkable. He has really, really done a ton for me. He really, I can't really thank the man enough for all he has done over the years for me. Really, it's just remarkable. I've had other ones that I mentor. I've got a person who is Persian. I got a optometrist. I've got this guy who's a little bit on the wacky side in Oklahoma. A couple of them I talk to. And my study buddy, I've got one in New Square. If you look up who New Square is, I study with him, and I got my friend in Muncie. So I have 1, 2, 3, 4. I got 6 study buddies on Sunday, which is really cool. So therefore, I can't impress upon you enough to find somebody to study with. Okay?